Luckily, the deputy and his family were not in the house at the time, and no one was injured. But this is something that I will not tolerate, the sheriff of Paulding County will not tolerate, and law enforcement will not tolerate. I've been to law enforcement funerals, too many, over the years, and I've buried one of my own, and that's the most devastating thing I've ever done. We, contrary to sometimes you folks, the news media, and other groups, seem to be at war with law enforcement today. We're not at war with you. We're out here to protect you, and as you've seen, we'll give our life for you if we have to. But I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure that the people that work for me and the people that wear the badge are protected. And the reason for this $10,000 reward, which I'm told has grown to about $12,500, that's based on citizens and people on Facebook offering money. I can't guarantee the extra money. I can with some of the folks that do it, but some of them I just don't know. But $2,500 in additional money has been offered from Facebook folks. So we're serious about this. There are not any resources that I won't use. As I said last night, we will spare no expense in finding out who did this. Do you have any questions? I'm here to ask.
Has the Facebook post led to a number of tips pouring in? Have you gotten any credible leads?
You know, we've got information. I wouldn't call them credible leads at this point. We're checking out everything that comes in.
Have you spoken to the deputy?
Yes.
How's he doing? How's his wife?
Well, he's under the circumstances, they're both doing very well. Before I made this public, I talked to him and his wife about how they felt about me doing this and it becoming a very public thing. So they want me to find who did this, and I want to find them, but they're doing pretty good.
If he was targeted because he is a deputy, how can deputies in the county or any county in Georgia feel safe right now? We've got people coming out doing this.
Well, you don't feel safe. That's just the reality of the job now. We don't know what's out there. We don't know what's behind the next tree. We are very visible. We wear uniforms. We drive marked cars. So if somebody wants to target law enforcement, it's a very easy thing to do. And it's happening all over this country. In Dallas, how many people died? How many cops died?
Is there any conversation about changing protocol about officers, deputies bringing their work patrol cars home?
No.
Maybe only using personal vehicles?
No. No. We're going to be what we are. We're not going to hide from you. But if you hurt us or try to hurt us, we're coming after you with all we got.
What do you need from the public right now? What do you need from the public right now?
Well, the public's just so supportive. I mean, you guys have access to Facebook and the internet and everything that I've heard, not one negative thing has been said. You know, I think by and large, the public supports law enforcement. And I think by and large, law enforcement supports the public. You know, as long as there's good and evil in this world, we're going to clash. But all in all, the people are good to us. But don't hurt my people is the message I'm trying to send.
In speaking with the deputy's wife, she had mentioned that.
I'm sorry, you're pretty good at that.
We got that there. She had mentioned that they have a young child who typically by routine at around 8 o'clock, they would be kind of in the area of the home that happened to get shot up. Fortunately, the child was away with family and they were out for a walk. Nobody was home at the time. But can you just speak to, I guess, the potential of what could have been on any given night that you know, this family was sitting right where the home was shot up?
Sure. You're exactly right. Normally they're in that home. And normally at that time they might be headed toward bed. And one of the projectiles landed on one of the beds. So, you know, the danger, the possibility of something extreme happening was very real. I think God was just with him.
For something like this to reach Douglas County, Paulding County, it's certainly a neighborhood setting that someone would have to go out of their way. And do you think this may have been, other homes could have also been hit in all of this? Other people could have been injured? And sure. I guess your surprise factor to hear that, you know, more rural community, something like this would be happening, a brazen shooting of this nature?
Well, you know, I'd like to think that, but we live in a different world today. We live in a world where people all of a sudden are anti-everything, and they're anti-law enforcement, they're anti-government, period. Some are anti-white, some are anti-black. It's a sad situation, it really is. The only way that we get over all this, in my opinion, is we come together and not divide and get further apart. I wish you guys, the news media, would help do that. The truth is the truth. If I investigate a case and I'm strictly looking for a conviction, then the truth gets the story. If you're a news reporter and you're looking for the best story and not just the truth, then sometimes the truth gets the story. And what we all have to do is be truthful. I can't sensationalize what happens at the Douglas County Sheriff's Office. And I pray to God that you will not sensationalize what happens in this community. Your job is to tell the truth, isn't it? My job is to look for the truth. And once we start to focus on that word truth and we get committed to it, then things are going to get better.
Just a quick question. Are you releasing the deputy's name?
No.
Okay.
Can you talk a little bit to the shell casings not being on the scene? We've heard that it could be a revolver in a vehicle or cleaned it up.
Well, all those things are possibility. if it was a lone driver and he rolled down the passenger side window as he drove by and he shot the gun would still be inside the car and the shell cases would remain inside the car. It tells me that the person, if it's an automatic, didn't have his hand out the window, that he had it inside the window. But I'm sure there's a lot of other possibilities as to why the shell casings are not there. But there is no doubt that somebody drove by that house, fired 6 to 10 shots, and hit that house 3, 4, 5 times.
So you definitely kind of leaning towards a car was in this neighborhood.
Well, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think it was a car.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Have there been any recent cases of anyone expressing, you know, they're disgruntled? Have there been other, you know, to a much lesser degree, kind of bizarre circumstances that you're aware of that maybe you can paint a picture of who might be behind it?
No. This is a great community. We work together. You know, we're all cognizant of what's going on across the country. But this community, during this entire process, has come together. And we're meeting on a weekly basis with different groups in the community, trying to share our ideas and how to make things better. I don't think we're part of the fad or whatever you want to call it, where something happens in another state and we protest. There's things that happen all across this country that all of us don't like. There's things that people do that all of us don't like. There's no reason, in my opinion, and I bet in most people's opinion, if something happens in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to go kill 6 or 7 Dallas cops. What did Dallas PD have to do with what happened in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, or Baton Rouge, Louisiana, or Baltimore, Maryland? There's a group of people that are trying to give a message that they don't like the way they're being treated. Killing cops is not the way to get that message out, does it? Does it invoke the news media, and does it invoke rage on both sides? It does. But people are dying as a result of it. There's little kids that don't have a parent anymore because of it. And I know that the other side can argue with us happening on our side too. But to go out and kill people, to try to send that kind of message, that's a long way to do it. If we're going to succeed in this country, it's got to be together and not apart and not divided. And we got to figure that out. And, you know, we can send people to the moon and invent things called the internet. And we're smart. We're really intelligent people. But we can't figure out how to get along. Isn't that amazing? And the way to do that is the truth. Yes, sir.
Just going to ask, I know you mentioned about the issues across the country and how people view each side, but could this also have been retaliation to this deputy because of an investigation in the county?
It could have. I mean, it could be anything. You know, do I know or do I have any evidence of any of that? No, I don't. But nobody knows the reason that person shot except that person. And the point I'm trying to make and the bigger statement I'm trying to make is we can do this together. There's no chance of us doing it divided. That's what I'm trying to say.
Deputy's been with the department for how long?
I'm just not, I don't mean to be picky, but I'm just not going to release any information on him or his family.
Are you fearful that they could come back and target this home again?
Sure. Anything's possible. I mean, we don't know. And we don't know if the guy just said, oh, there's a cop car, bam, bam, bam. He may not know this deputy. But he may. But this deputy is not in a position to give calls or rise to someone that would, you know, want to kill somebody, in my opinion.
Are you all going to step up patrol around that area?
Well, my good friend behind you, Sheriff Gary Gulledge, is in charge of that area, and I guarantee you he's going to take care of us. He feels the same way I do about other law enforcement officers and that community.
I just wanted to touch base on your Facebook post was awfully impassioned, and you had even had the line in there, I'm paraphrasing here, I won't, you know, hesitate to use any resources to come find you until you're caught. And I think that's what a lot of people are latching on to, is the sheriff taking to Facebook and making this impassioned plea to the community to kind of step up here and help you guys find him. Can you just speak to your personal anger and sadness or whatever emotions you're going through that the last 24 hours?
Yeah, I buried a deputy back in 2005, I think. And I still deal with his family and his daughters. And it was the most horrific experience that I've ever had to deal with in my entire life. And when somebody shoots at one of my deputy's houses, it promotes some responses from inside me that makes me want to do everything that I can and say everything that I can to make sure that people understand we're not going to put up with that. And if there's anything that I can do from a legal standpoint, I'm going to do it to catch this guy.
Any idea if there was one person, more than one person involved?
No,
I'm just trying to figure that out.
Know.
Yeah.
Any witnesses?
I hope it was more than one. I hope there was 10 of them, because that's 9 witnesses.
Did anybody in the neighborhood report seeing a suspicious vehicle around? Because at 8 o'clock, it's still...
They heard the shots. One man was doing some work inside the house, and he heard 6 to 10 shots, and other people heard shots, but nobody saw a vehicle. So... We're depending on the public to come out and speak out if they know anything and help us solve this case. And that's the way it is in 80% or more of the cases. We can't do our job without you. And hopefully that $10,000 or $12,500 will entice somebody who would have probably done the right thing anyway to do the right thing.
Have you ever heard of this happening before in your community?
Yes. Yes, I have. But I've had a long career. I've been in law for 45 years, so about everything's happened during that period of time.
And he still went to work today, right?
Huh?
He still went to work today?
Yeah.
And he speaks to kind of, you know, I'm sure it shook him, but his commitment to his job.
Yeah. That's what we do.
I think you covered it all.
Huh?
I think you covered it all.
I think we did.
Anything else you want to add?
No. I did everything but pass the plate.
Are you a preacher also?
No.
No. Sounds like a Southern Baptist preacher talking about passing the plate.
Right. Thank y'all. I ain't a preacher anymore.
Thank you.